Today on Answers with Bayless Conley.
Been betrayed? He's holding you. Financial tailspin? He's holding you. Battling sickness? He's holding you. You just got bad news and it's turned your world upside down? He's holding you. Trust. Rest. He can hold you up.
Hi, I'm Bayless Conley. I've been a pastor going on 4 decades, but if you'd seen some of the earlier chapters of my life, you probably never would have guessed that I would have ended up serving in gospel ministry. Growing up, I was raised a normal Southern California kid, but as a teenager, my life quickly spiraled into drug and alcohol addiction and a search for answers. After a number of near-death experiences, I came to know Jesus and experienced His life-changing power. I found out that He was what I'd been searching for and that there were answers in His Word. In life, we all face uncertainty, whether it's financial troubles, relationship valleys, a health crisis, or just trying to discover your purpose. One thing is for certain, God sees you, He loves you, and no matter what you're facing, He has the answers. I want to open it up tonight with something that is incredibly important for every believer and needs to be imprinted upon our minds and upon our hearts. It's how we're supposed to live. I'm going to talk to you tonight about living a life of trust. There's a verse in Proverbs that most of you could probably quote, Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. It's because God's ways are not our ways. And the truth is, sometimes the Lord's way can be diametrically opposed to conventional human wisdom. And there are times that God may require you to do that which from a human vantage point is utterly ridiculous before He'll do the miraculous. And if you lean on your own understanding, you say, well, look, I'm not doing that. The math doesn't add up. That doesn't make sense. I don't understand that. Well, don't lean to your own understanding, but take His precepts as your inheritance and trust Him with all of your heart. You know, even on our money, I have a dollar bill here. On all of our money, the words are printed, "In God we trust," printed right there. Well, you know what? It needs to be imprinted, emblazoned on the heart of every believer. In God, we trust. God's timing for righting wrongs, answering prayers, judging the wicked, fulfilling prophecy, very rarely coincides with our timing. Have you ever noticed that? Ecclesiastes 3:11 says, He has made everything beautiful in its time. There's a time and a purpose for everything under heaven, my friend. In Ephesians 1:11, it says that God works all things according to the counsel of His own will. He doesn't work them according to the counsel of our will, but He works all things according to the counsel of His own will, and He makes everything beautiful in its time. I want to read to you a little bit from Acts chapter 7, from a sermon that was preached there. Beginning in verse 5, it says, "But even when Abraham had no child, he promised to give it to him for a possession and to his descendants after him." That is, before Abraham even had a child, God promised to give him the promised land for his own possession, as well as the possession of his descendants after him. And any of us that know the scriptures, we know that. God said, look, you know, look to the north, south, east, and west. Every place that you see, I've given that to you. You're going to inherit this land. It will be your possession and the possession of your descendants. You move down in that same chapter, Acts 7, in verse 17, it says, "But when the time of the promise drew near," everyone say the time. "But when the time of the promise drew near, which God had sworn to Abraham, the people grew and multiplied in Egypt." Now, When the time of the promise drew near, Abraham has already been dead for about 500 years. Abraham lived with a confident trust that God's promise would be fulfilled, knowing that it would not be in his own lifetime. And God is looking for men and women like that. True, Abraham was blessed during his earthly lifetime, but most of what he did and most of what he lived for was for future generations. That is important to God. And so, eventually, Moses is born, the one that God will use to bring Abraham's descendants into possession of the land promised to Abraham. And even in the story of Moses, we can learn quite a bit more about trusting God with timing. Everyone say timing. Timing is so important when it comes to trust. Some of you listening to me, you have been given a promise by God. You've genuinely picked up on God's calling for your life. Are you willing to trust the timing to Him? Trust has a lot to do with timing, and the timing is God's part. I know everybody's not liking this so far. Listen, the message may not get better for you. I'm just warning you. Matthew 11, verses 28 and 29, Jesus is speaking. He said, "Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." He didn't say, "Come to me, I'll give you more burdens. I'm going to add more to your troubles." No, he said, "I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls." When we come to Jesus and put our trust in Him, He gives us rest. Hebrews 4 and 3 says, "For we who have believed do enter that rest." Resting rather than stressing out. Resting rather than worrying. You've done all you can do. You've put things in God's hand. Now rest. Let your soul rest in Him. That's a key element of trust. Resting. Now, there's a minister. He's been in heaven for quite a few years now, and he wasn't a close friend. He was a friend, though, and ran a very large, very influential ministry that was touching the globe. And there was an old friend of his that came to visit him, and this guy that came to visit happened to pastor a church. And so this guy that I know is taking him around the campus and showing him, you know, all the different branches and aspects of the ministry and, you know, the outreaches they're having and, you know, the beautiful buildings, etc. But this pastor that came was just going on and on about his troubles and how bad his life was and how difficult things were in the church and this and that. And this friend of mine finally said, "You know, you need to roll your troubles over on God. You need to give your worries to Him." And the guy just snapped at him. He says, "Well, it's easy for you to say. You've got a perfect life. I could do that if, you know, I had everything going for me, you got going for you." And my friend said, "Well, you know what? Normally I wouldn't do this because I don't like to talk about my troubles. But let me share some things with you. This just might help you." And he began to share the stuff that was going on in his life and in his ministry. And he was one that, with some of these self-proclaimed defenders of the faith, would go over his messages with a fine-tooth comb, take one little sound bite out, and then write negative articles about that sound bite and actually record it and send people to stand, you know, in front of his meetings and play this little sound bite. "You're going in there. This guy said this. That's his voice, isn't it? Listen." And the little sound bite sounded terrible if you took it out of its setting, out of its context. And actually, he would even explain why he used that language, and this is what he meant by the language. But you take it out of all of that, and it sounded terrible. And so, you know, people are going after him hammer and tongs, so he's got to deal with all of that, as well as trusting God for a huge monthly budget. And then there was a bunch of other things and some stuff that I know of that, I don't know if he shared the fullness of them, but I know that some of his key staff people had been involved in some pretty major sin. There had been immorality and adultery taking place, and he had to navigate all that. Families, you know, marriage of some of the, I mean, key people in the ministry. Marriage broke up and scandal and the whole thing. So he's got to navigate all of those things. And when he got done, this guy that had so many problems looked at him and says, how do you even live? He said, I do what I'm telling you to do. He says, I get on my knees, I make my request known to God, and I cast my cares on him, and then I rest. You know, some that just look at other people think they've got it so good, they've got it so easy. If you walked in their shoes for a few miles, you would never want to take off your own shoes ever again. Rest. God wants us to rest. Look, in this world, we're going to have tribulation. But Jesus said, be of good cheer, I've overcome the world. And he says, come to me and I'll give you rest for your soul. And sometimes when you're in the middle of a storm, my friend, some people need to be put out and other people need to be brought in. If you're fighting for your life, you need to bring people into your circle, people that will encourage your faith and trust God with you, people that love the Word and believe the Word.
Are you facing a problem that you need an answer to? In your health, in your relationships, in your finances, or maybe you feel stuck in a situation, lacking a clear direction or purpose? You can find answers for your life. You can have direction and purpose with Answers for Each Day, our online daily devotional. Pastor Bayless unlocks the truth of God's Word and shows you how to find answers for your life in an easy-to-read format. Each devotional shows how easy it is to have an intimate relationship with God by living a practical, faith-filled life in Christ. When you go online right now to BaylessConley.com and sign up for this free resource, these answers of biblical wisdom and teaching are sure to inspire you to dive deeper into what God has for your life. You can receive these inspirational devotionals today for free when you sign up at BaylessConley.com. These beautifully written daily devotionals will deepen your biblical understanding, give you practical steps to create more intimacy in your relationships, and improve your spiritual and physical health. God's Word has the answers for your life. When you go online right now to BaylessConley.com and sign up, each devotional will challenge you to live better, improve your attitude, and walk out the practical solutions found in God's Word. The Answers for Each Day devotional will strengthen your faith and reignite your passion to pursue God's answers for your life. It's absolutely free. Go online right now, BaylessConley.com, to sign up. That's BaylessConley.com.
Been betrayed? He's holding you. Financial tailspin? He's holding you. Battling sickness? He's holding you. You just got bad news and it's turned your world upside down. He's holding you. Trust. Rest. He can hold you up. Enjoy the ride. I want to read to you an interesting little section of scripture from Acts 27. Acts 27 and verse 14. But not long after, a tempestuous headwind arose called Euroclodon. So when the ship was caught and could not head into the wind, we let her drive. And running under the shelter of an island called Clauda, we secured the skiff with difficulty. And when they had taken it on board, they used cables to undergird the ship. Our trust must have the undergirding of God's Word if it's going to survive the storms of life. It must be undergirded. Let me put it a different way. Trusting without scripture to stand on is like building a bridge with no supports underneath. It will collapse under pressure. And I was in the backcountry once with some friends. We went to a really remote area. It was about almost a full 2-day hike in, you know, carrying our packs. And it was an area that not many people frequented because there wasn't actually a trail. You had to go cross country. It was a place my father and I had found when I was a kid when we were backpacking, and I decided to take some friends there. Now, they thought I was crazy till we arrived at this little pristine lake, and we set up our camp, and I went over to the other side of the lake to do a little bit of fly fishing. So I'm by myself, and I'm standing on the edge of the lake. I've taken my boots off, rolled my pant legs up, and I'm standing in the water, throwing out a fly. And I didn't realize, but there was a fairly large black bear that was sneaking up on me from behind. Probably never seen a human being before. This place was so remote. And all of a sudden, I heard a boulder shift. I turned around, and this bear stands up, probably as close for me to Pastor Robert. I had nowhere to go except into the lake. And so I bent down, picked up rocks, and started screaming at the bear and hitting rocks together. And I guess I had a lot of adrenaline going because these rocks were breaking apart in my hands. Anyway, I'm not going to go into the whole story, but in this encounter with the bear, I actually stepped on a log that I thought was solid, and it wasn't solid. My leg went right through it. Now, the bear obviously didn't kill me. Here I am. But I did get injured from that log. I ended up with a hole about diameter of a quarter in the front of my leg, about an inch deep, with a bunch of jagged pieces of wood stuck in it that we had to, you know, dig out and then tend to it. But it looked solid, that log did, but there was nothing underneath it. It had rotted out in there, nothing underneath it to support it. Your faith must have the promises of God to support it. It must be undergirded with the Word of God, otherwise it will not hold you up. God's promises are the support beams for our trust. Psalm 18 and verse 30 says, God's way is perfect. The Lord's promise always proves to be true. He protects those who trust in Him. Psalm 56, 3 and 4, whenever I'm afraid, I will trust in You. In God, I will praise His word. In God, I have put my trust. I will not fear what can flesh do to me. Psalm 119, verse 92, unless Your law had been my delight, I would then have perished in my affliction. Listen, when you're in a storm, your best friends are the Word of God and people of like precious faith that love the Word of God. Those are the two best friends you have when you're in the middle of trouble. Sometimes when you're in the middle of a storm, my friend, some people need to be put out and other people need to be brought in. If you're fighting for your life, you need to bring people into your circle, people that will encourage your faith and trust God with you, people that love the Word and believe the Word. And maybe temporarily, you need to put people outside of that circle that would tear down in your faith and ridicule you and scorn you. I'm telling you, in the middle of a battle, it's very important who you surround yourself with. Your best friends in the battle, in the storm, God's Word, and people that love God's Word. Psalm 9 and verse 10, and those who know Your name will put their trust in You. For You, Lord, have not forsaken those who seek You. Seeking is a part of trust. Trusting God, though it does have to do with resting on His promises, that's part of the equation, but trusting God is not altogether passive. As we trust, we should be seeking Him for guidance. Whatever you're facing right now, listen, it didn't take God by surprise. He created a pathway to victory before the difficulty ever reared its head, and He will guide you if you wait on Him and seek Him for wisdom. He will guide you. Let me read to you. This is from the Passion Translation, 1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13. It's beautiful. It says, we all experience times of testing, which is normal for every human being, but God will be faithful to you. He will screen and filter the severity, nature,
and timing of every test or trial you face so that you can bear it. And each test is an opportunity to trust Him more. For along with every trial, God has provided for you a way of escape that will bring you out of it victoriously. There is a way. You may be facing something right now that seems absolutely impossible for you to get out of. You feel like you're locked in. You're not. Before the problem came, God made a pathway of escape to bring you out victoriously. Before the problem ever arose, in eternity past, God sat down in the council room of heaven, talked about your life, planned, the next step you're supposed to take. And if you'll seek Him, He'll show you what to do. Another interesting story that a friend of mine told, they had given a storm alert and told people that they shouldn't try and get across this mountain pass. It was in Colorado, but this guy decided to do it anyway. Again, a Christian. And he didn't make it over the pass before the snowstorm hit. He got snowed in up the top of the pass. And it wasn't a matter. He was so far up, couldn't walk down. And the temperature would drop so low there, chances are, 48 hours, he would probably freeze to death. And as the story goes, he's in his car, God, I'm sorry. This was foolish of me, trying to get ahead of this thing. Why am I in such a hurry all the time? He said, forgive me, Lord, and God, show me what to do. And this voice in his heart said, start flashing SOS with your headlights. Three short, three long, three more short. International sign for SOS. And he thought to himself, that's stupid. I'm on the top of a mountain pass. I'm snowed in up here. Heard it again. Flash SOS. So for the next couple hours, he just flashed. SOS, three short, three long, three short. Well, it just happened that while he was flashing SOS, there was a commuter plane going high overhead. And it just happened that the moment he was flashing that there was a parting in the clouds. And it just happened on that side of the airplane, there was a retired sheriff. And it just happened that when the clouds parted, the sheriff looked out the window and he recognized the SOS signal. He got the pilot, to call it in, and they went up there with some heavy equipment and had the guy out and saved his life. Listen, there's something you can do, even if your problem is your own making. God will help you. And it is true. Our God does amazing things. But I think sometimes people tend to think, well, yeah, but I couldn't expect God to do anything unless it somehow relates to this, massive plan that He has in place, to reach the nations for Christ. And certainly we understand that reaching the lost is God's top priority. Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. But the truth is God is interested in you. He's interested in your needs. He's interested in the struggles that you are going through, and He wants to help you. It's not like He folds His arms and says, well, look, that's just below me. That's not important. I don't care about your rent. Come on, we've got a world that we need to save. Yes, we want to reach the world for Christ, and we're giving and we're praying and we're speaking up and doing all those things, but God is interested in you paying your rent. God is interested in your children getting back on track. God is interested about you being free from those migraine headaches. God is interested about you having peace with your relative and your family member. God's interested in you. My friend, He loves you more than you have the capacity to understand it. And if you'll cry out to Him from a sincere heart, He will help you. Listen, it's not a coincidence you're listening to me right now. Our God is a very present help in times of trouble. He's present there with you. He knows your story. He hasn't lost your address. It's not a coincidence you're listening to me right now. He wants to help you. Father, I just pray for my friend right now that their heart would be lifted, that hope would arise in their heart, and they would turn their eyes towards You and toward the promises in Your Word, and that they would put their trust in You alone. And friend, whoever calls on the name of the Lord, whoever puts their trust in Him will not be disappointed.
I also wanted to take a moment, and I do this just about every time, I wanted to say a big thank you to our partners, those that support what we're doing. We take these messages around the world in 11 different languages right now, more than 100 nations, and we couldn't do that without people that help. And if you've never become a partner, pray about doing it. My friend, we are changing lives in Jesus' name. Whenever we enter into a new year, people generally think about all the things they want to do differently, and they think about the things they want to accomplish. Well, I have written a brand new book for a time such as this. It's called Great Pursuits, dealing with the things that really matter in life, the things that God wants us to pursue. I want to encourage you, go online and get the book. I know it will be a rich blessing to you. Great Pursuits.
Everyone is chasing something. The perfect job, the perfect relationship, financial security. Many of the things we pursue are good things, but do they have eternal value? Are they really the things that matter? In Bayless Conley's brand new book, Great Pursuits, Chasing What Matters Most in Life, Bayless reveals the things that God says are worth pursuing. From purpose to perspective, happiness to hospitality, Bayless gives you the practical guide to finding the things in life worth chasing, and then the easy ways to pursue them every day. When you go online right now to BaylessConley.com and get Great Pursuits, for a gift of $19 or more, you'll uncover how simple obedience to God's plan can unlock the passion, purpose, and healing available to you. God created you for so much more than you could ever imagine. The life He offers, the promises He's made, and the purpose you have are significant. That's why we should use every moment chasing after God's best. Available in physical, digital, and audiobook versions for a gift of just $19. Great Pursuits will show you how to connect with your purpose by following God's Word. You'll learn how to grow in character both personally and within your relationships. What you pursue matters. In order to lead a life of victory, make sure you're pursuing the right things with Great Pursuits. Don't miss this special offer. Go online right now to BaylessConley.com to get Great Pursuits. That's BaylessConley.com.
We're grateful for the friends and partners of Answers with Bayless Conley who make this program possible.